I remember I met Jazz at work. I was working. I was putting stuff up, putting clothes up, and she walked past, and she walked, and she doubled back and looked back. And I remember, because she it was the weirdest thing, she just came out of nowhere and said, "People say I look like Angela Bassett." And it was so weird, but it was so cute because she did. And that was the very first time I met Jazz. And from there, it was a real slow process. She would come by and spoil my dog, our dog now. She would come by and kill time, just watch the office. And I always thought, I don't even know if this girl likes me or if she's just weird. And eventually, I did find out that we did have feelings for each other. And I'm glad that we did. And I'm glad that it worked out that way. Because we did all the friend stuff first. And I wouldn't any other way. All the times just doing nothing. And I think everybody in a relationship will kind of appreciate those times where you're just happy to be around the other person. And that's how I am with Jazz today. I'm not nervous at all, not worried. I've been looking forward to this day since May 26th of last year when I proposed to her. So I'm ready. And I'm so ready just to see her come down the aisle, and I'm just ready to tell the world what I've been telling her for the past almost 10 years. But now we're inviting everyone to join us, and just gonna let everyone else see it. Our beautiful family with me, Jazz, and Cam. And I love both of them more than anything in the world. Without one, there's no other. So I definitely appreciate where me and Jazz started, where we're at, and where we're going to be. I just want her to know that I love her with all my heart. I love your family. And I'm so glad that you're going to be stuck with me for the rest of your life. I love you.
So me and you met at Ralph Lauren, store 267. Who would have ever thought that we would end up together, because you thought I was a weirdo and that I talked too much, but too bad, you got me, and I still do. I'm glad that we ended up together. We've been through some hard times, good times. You have a beautiful daughter. Maybe one day we'll make a bigger family. Can't hold you to it. But don't know what else to say. That I love you, always will love you. You got me forever and always. I can't wait to be Mrs. Cherrier, whatever, because you always say I butcher it, but it's okay. And I'm glad that now I have another brother. Shout out to you, Casey. Another sister. Shout out to you, Asia. You know I'm not good with words because I butcher them all the time. You always picking on me for it, but it's okay. I'm still messing up. But I just want to let you know we're getting down to the crunch time. It's about here. I want to say I love you, and we're always and forever.
Sitting together in holy wedlock and has witnessed the same before God and this company by the state of North Carolina, I pronounce you husband and wife. Taylor Ewing Fisher Martin.
But Jazz has always been there for me. She has always been my ride or die, like from going to every super jam with my mama to getting kicked out of the movies to even rescuing baby kittens at the hospital parking lot. I remember my mom rented us some scary movies one night, and one was The Grudge, and I was just afraid to take a shower. So Jazz sat in the bathroom on the toilet and talked to me while I showered. And that is a best friend. Like, she sat in there the entire time. But I want to thank you guys for letting me be a part of this day, for my goddaughter Cam, and I'm just so happy that she found the man of her dreams. I wish you guys many, many more years of happiness, many memories, and a lifetime of love. And thank you everyone for making this day possible, since I'm so happy my best friend didn't become a Brazilian.
Baby faces every time I close my eyes. Give it up again for the couple's first name.